All right, let's begin now again. Once again, you'll be comfortable hopefully in English.
Yes,
English,
sir.
Okay, no problem. No? Yes, fine. Because I'm trying to keep taxation only in English. Law, you can keep it Hindi English means kind of. It's okay, till here. Chalega? Fine. So let us quickly recap whatever small things we have done yesterday or in the last lecture. What we were discussing? About first of all about intermediate, right? About intermediate and then trying for both the groups, right? All 8 papers are important, exemptions set off, all of that. Next 8-9 months, lots of hard work, dedication is required. Even if you reach at whatever time at home, even if you have to get up early, you know, and travel a lot. And after that,
I was so exhausted.
Everybody was exhausted. Because it is obviously after quite a long time, we are getting used to this kind of new timetable. Since like last 1 year, we were sitting at home, chilled. But now again, you have to 10 hours of sitting in class, traveling of almost 1 hour to and fro. After that, hopefully homework and opening of books. None of you opened the books. There are no books only. First of all, to begin with. That's why, very casual. That's fine. So, that we discuss. Yeah. Then we discuss about what? Little bit of taxes. Little bit of basics of tax we were discussing, isn't it? How much that Apple Inc. was paying tax? How much? Apple Incorporated? Less, did you all research? Less than 1% of its global whatever profits or whatever income they are making. You know, one of the wealthiest country, it is a country only, as is now. That much of income it has. One of the wealthiest company in the world, but pays less than almost 1% of their total profits. Why that was that? Why that was happening?
Bermuda.
And? Segregation of lots of institutions. They have floated lots of companies, not in just USA. There are Bermuda Islands, Cayman Islands, British Virgin Islands, Mauritius, then Ireland. Ireland, you know where it is? In obviously Europe, on the left of UK. Finnish countries.
Left of the UK.
Left of UK, those, there are three countries, no? Three kingdoms, no? UK, we can say that. Three. Great Britain, Ireland and Scotland. Correct, correct. Yeah, Ireland, so that is part of it. Now, Ireland has a very, very encouraging to the investors kind of tax policies. Obviously, you might not know how much is the tax rate and all right now in India or wherever, but let me just give you an example. In India, it is almost like 30% for corporate. Corporate tax rate is 30%. There are other rates also, but let us say, for example, 30%. At Ireland, it is almost 10 to 15%. So why do you think India has 30%, but Ireland, which is like on the left hand side of UK, let us say it is kind of a developed country, why it would be having 10-15% only? Population size is too much.
In India,
that's why we need more taxes to feed more people.
People paying taxes is large in percentage compared to India.
Okay, so people paying tax are more, that's why lower tax
from every person can be accumulated.
Can be there, alright, yes. In Mauritius, there is no income tax culture. Or you can say there is no tax on capital gains. We will obviously come to that, what is capital gains and all. You know little bit of revenue versus capital. Have you heard of that? In accounts, maybe foundation, yes. Revenue versus capital. What do you mean by revenue versus capital? What do you mean by revenue in that case?
Revenue is, processes of business, practice of business.
Okay, and capital?
Capital is? Gains out of selling capital asset or something.
Okay, fine. Can I say income or revenue earned from day-to-day activities is
revenue.
And then from one-off means rare or not so regular, that can be capital income, right? So obviously any kind of income, there will be tax. Like simply when you say income tax, it is what tax on income. So it can be any kind of income, isn't it? It can be any kind of income. Can it be illegal income also? Legal or illegal? I am saying it is illegal. Selling of drugs?
No. That thing is illegal. Income is income.
Even after selling of drugs, okay? That income can also be taxed. But expenditures, okay? Expenditures you understand, right? Income and then you have expenditure. But expenditure incurred for creation of that illegal business, that will not be allowed. That expenditure will not be allowed. So illegal expenditure, for example, bribing, or you can say any kind of what do we call it as protection money. In Hindi, we call it as hafta, vasuli bhai. Hai na? Somebody is coming and taking some money or some kind of involuntary contribution, vargani or whatever you want to call it, right? That kind of stuff, if it is illegal, or you can say not allowed, okay, you are paying something extra which is outside the legal framework, paying expenditure, that will not be allowed as an expenditure legally. Not even in your company's act, wo to chhod do, that is different, but not even in your income tax. But when it is coming to income side, when it is, we are talking about inflow, any kind of income, department will say it is taxable. It is to be taxed. So income as such, there is no difference when it is to be taxed. Any kind of income it can be. It can be revenue now, it can be capital, it can be legal, illegal, right? So I was telling you about Mauritius and capital gain tax. When you are having some kind of capital income, there is no tax in Mauritius on the concept of capital income. But in India, obviously we have it. Now obviously there are different countries with different policies. Now if I compare Singapore and Mauritius, what is Mauritius famous for?
Tourism.
The industry mainly is based on tourism, isn't it? So their main income is from tourism, isn't it? You might be aware in Dubai there is again no income tax. There is no direct tax rather in Dubai. They are quite happy and they are quite rich. But there are lots of indirect taxes in, you can see, all those UAE countries, right? Now Mauritius is mainly dependent on tourism and that kind of income, day-to-day activities. And then they have exempted, or they are saying there is no tax on this kind of capital gain income. But whereas in India, it is obviously taxed. So from countries to countries, there are different tax regimes. Regimes means mechanisms or rules and policies. But why? Why different? Requirements are different, okay, yes. Governance is different, the policies might be different, though. You can say intention might be different, or you can say planning might be different. Geographical is also important conditions, or based on that. Now, what then you can say this two areas, two any kind of two areas, even two cities for that matter, are they same? Can you immediately compare rural versus urban? Are they same? So when we say two locations are not same, two states even are not same, how can two countries be exactly same? And the requirements of the country might be different. Requirements itself might be different. So when Mauritius is already doing well in tourism, but they want to attract lots of investments from outside their country, they are making it very much tax friendly. We call it as what? Tax friendly. That you come in our country and invest, but we are going to make it very, very easy for you to do business through your. So lots of foreign investors, they use this kind of route, or you can say this kind of, you can say all these areas, and from there they make their investments. I'll give you an example as such. There are many, many foreign, you can say, companies, they are investing in India through Mauritian route, through Mauritius. That means what? They incorporate a company in Mauritius. Okay, they incorporate a company in Mauritius, and now this Mauritian company, they also at time directly invest. I was researching in this case of SBI last year. We had no SBI cards, I think SBI cards IPO was there, huh? SBI cards IPO we had no last year. That time we were researching, and I was just going through their prospectus. We will learn all these words in our syllabus also, prospectus. That time that one of the companies had come into that prospectus, the name. That SBI cards company's holding company was SBI Bank. SBI Bank 60%. But remaining 40% was by a Mauritian company. I think it was CA Rover. CA, it was some short form, and ROVER, Rover. It was a Mauritian company. It was holding 40% of that. So SBI Bank itself 60% and 40% by this CA Rover Mauritian company. And now that Mauritian company, now pay attention. It had invested in SBI cards in 2015 around, something around in 2015. And IPO, that whatever they are selling the shares in 2020, sorry, last year, okay? And now whatever shares they had purchased in SBI cards in 2015, they were selling now in 2020. They are selling shares, okay, Delio? So this kind of income is what? Is it revenue income or capital income? What do you think?
Capital.
This is capital income from the investment. They had invested in SBI cards, barabara, right? And they were selling it after a couple of years. So it was a capital income. But they were incorporated where? In Mauritian company, in Mauritius. And what did I tell you just now, sometime back? There is no capital gain tax in Mauritius, right? So this kind of high level planning, international planning, and there are so much of planning. Now all this planning can help you to bring down your tax level to just 1%, even if you're Apple, isn't it? So there are so many even commissions or committees, even in European countries, which are so much behind Apple and Google also, that you are making so much of money out of our countries, but you're paying no taxes in our country. So that is kind of, you can say, always a fight going on between taxes of different countries. And always there is a professional, or you can say a team. We are trying to find loopholes in the tax system and, you know, bring the best out of it. Now, when I say Apple is paying just 1%, Apple is paying just 1% tax of their income, okay? Is it legal or illegal? Are they paying that 1% legally or illegally? They are paying legal, correct? Is it ethical or not? That is a different question. It is right now fitting in the framework of law, so it is legal. This is what we call it as tax planning. Are you understanding, Leo? So there is a, whatever you do within the framework, it is visible now. Whatever you do within the framework, you understand? Within the four corners of law, that is, if it is allowed, that is known as tax planning. Correct? So tax evasion, tax avoidance, that is different. Tax evasion and tax avoidance, that is different. And what is only legal or allowed is tax planning. So when the law says, or whatever, as per law, you are required to pay, let us say 30%, and then you are somehow bringing it down to 1%. Now you tell me, you imagine now, for such a rich company, if you are able to bring down its tax liability by 29%, that amount will run into billions of dollars. You as a tax professional can also demand 1% fees or whatever 29% they are saving. That is the scope. Now you may immediately are not going to meet, you know, Apple Inc. and all that client. But you, at least on your level, can try your best that if a person is paying 10 lakh rupees as tax, how can we bring it down legally, okay, to lower levels? And then you can obviously confidently ask for that. What, see, I saved you 2 lakh rupees. So I can very well demand 50,000 rupees or whatever, you know, your benefit and my benefit also, right? Do you have to physically work into something? Do you have to like slog for 8 to 10 hours with your blood and sweat to reduce the tax liability? No, it is all matter of mind, all intelligence. Our income tax at whatever you call it, we call it as our bread and butter, our Bible, our Gita, our Quran, everything. So your saving of someone's money is dependent only as such on your knowledge and its application. For that is what is important is your knowledge of tax, no? And all the loopholes and what is there and what is not there. So you need to have that much of, you can say, study in the subject of taxation. When I compare tax with other subject, see, in articleship you are going to do only these two things mainly, tax and audit. I don't want to say audit is not that good, but it is mainly about your physical activity in audit. You're actually checking some documentation, you're making some analysis. Obviously there is too much of scope in that. But tax again is not something you learn in one single day. Whoever is learning tax or into tax, they take lots of years, and that is how they get that kind of command or mastery in that subject. So it is not matter of you do it one season and you can say very comfortable with your tax. No, it takes lots of years to get that much of knowledge. Now any section is asked, what case laws are asked, what case laws were decided, what cases had happened in that particular, you can say, matter. You know, when I'm talking about the illegal and legal selling of drugs, or you can say earning income from selling of drugs is taxable, but that expenditure incurred for selling of drugs, expenditure, will not be allowed. Even this is what obviously one of the case studies, or you can say case laws, that judgment is given by court. Again, this knowledge is going to help you out, you know. And in main, one of the main work which we do in tax is only is mainly research. Lots and lots of what we do is but to what? Research. See, only if you do research, then you are in a position to reduce the tax liability, or you can say make it very much beneficial for your client as well. You know, that client is doing a particular transaction, then how can he save taxes? Then for that, what do you do? Lots of research. And that will come only if you're reading and reading and reading a lot. Okay, so tax may basically, this is will always be there, that we'll be reading a lot. from BARE Act, from rules, from case studies, notification circulars, all of that is there. That is what we are going to also learn. In this CA intermediate, let me tell you, I told you this yesterday also, that lots of this subject will be repeated in CA final. That means you are right now just scratching the surface. Means what? You are actually looking at this at the tip of the iceberg. The main iceberg is below the water, that is in CA final. But again, that will just give you again a kind of good expertise level. And before that, as it is, you are doing articleship. So here you are getting introduced to the subject. But let me tell you very honestly, the syllabus which we had in our time and the syllabus which you have, there is a lots of difference. Your syllabus has increased by 30-40% compared to last 10 years. And they are expecting that whatever you are going to do in articleship, that you are getting, you can say, exposed to itself in CA intermediate, the syllabus itself. And that also belongs, and that is also true for GST as well. But when I talk about both the departments, income tax as well as GST, both the fields or subjects, income tax is too much, you can say, time consuming, quite vast, wide, complex also. Because GST has come only recently. So there are little bit of less litigations. Litigation, you understand the word litigation? Have you heard of the word litigation? Suna hai kabhi? Kya hota hai? What is it?
Legal compliance.
Disputes. Litigation means dispute. Sometimes I can also call it as litigative matter. Litigative. Okay. So obviously when I am talking of dispute means how many parties are involved? At least two parties are involved and they are fighting. So when I talk about there is a dispute about or litigative matter about tax, then who do you think will be involved? Income tax department versus your client or whoever is the income tax payer. Are you understanding clear? Achha, what will be they fighting about? What do you think on a very general basic level? What will income tax department say?
More
tax. It is taxable. And what will your taxpayer or client say it is?
Not
that is what is the fight about. Isn't it? That is, we can call it as litigative matter. That is basically this matter goes on and goes on, that we will, that all we are going to learn and understand. Okay, till here. So we are going to learn lots of things in income tax, I'm telling you, by the end of this batch. And usually July is the season also, okay, of income tax and all that we are going to learn. But at least by the end of this batch, you will be able to file a simple basic income tax return, at least of your own. And obviously you can guide your family as well. At least the basics in this 3.5 months. That is what kind of syllabus we are going to learn, as well as practically also we are going to see that. Income tax returns, Form 16, 16A, you might have heard of all of that. That is also what we are going to learn. I mean, we are going to see in the batch, and if possible, after the end of batch, we will try to file your own. Anybody who is interested, we will file your income tax return live over here also. That also we can do. At least your 200 or 500 rupees is saved whenever you want to file your own income tax return. Okay? How many of you don't have PAN? PAN. Kiske paas nahi hai? PAN. Tumhare paas hai? Achha. Have you heard of that PAN? Aadhaar. Right? Yeah. So PAN is also there, and that was all we are going to see, and we'll see that as well. How to apply, where to apply, all that you can do. When I started yesterday law, which website I gave you?
mca.gov.in.
So even for income tax, please write down or somewhere you can, so at least mention two websites which I want to you to explore and keep handy. I want you to explore, or you can say, go through this website, that's it. Because again, we are also going to do that. Income Tax India .gov.in. For law, we had which one? mca.gov.in. So Income Tax India .gov.in. And other one, Income Tax India e-filing.gov.in. It is e-filing, no? Income Tax India e-filing.gov.in. Okay. Now, why am I giving all these websites? So that you can basically explore who the regulators. What do you mean by regulators, bachcho?
Income
इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट और फॉर योर कंपनीज MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, the department basically, right? They're going to regularize, you can say, control, supervise all this process in India. It is obviously a big department and very important department in India, right? So you can also understand when I told you a little bit yesterday that how much of the entire income of India is coming from taxes, almost 2/3 or 70%. So it is one of the most, you can say, important departments. It becomes very important for our country. Whoever are collecting our taxes, you know, the income tax department tomorrow, then your indirect taxes also, you know, so they become very important. So whatever website they have, you should go and check it out. The basic one is this one, okay. And now what are compliances we are going to do? For that we have this website, right, Telio? What do you mean by the word compliance? Sorry?
To do something that is required by law.
To do something which is required by law. Yes. What else? When we say about Companies Act compliances or Income Tax Act compliances, what do you mean by that? That means something you have to file, or you can say report. Are you understanding earlier, everybody? To file something or to report. To whom you will report?
The authorities.
The regulators. Correct. See, what I'm trying to tell you or do over here is get these terms in your mind. Okay? So authorities, when we'll say, they're kind of regulators, right? For capital markets, you understand, stock exchanges and all. Who is the regulator over there?
SEBI.
For banks?
RBI.
Understood? For companies? MCA. And for income tax, you have income tax department office. So we have one more authority, we will come to that also. CBDT and all. We'll see that. Understood here? So all these things we are going to understand, right? We were discussing a little bit of statistics, right? We are collecting taxes for what? All 135 CR people, 135 crore, right? And contributed by just hardly 4%, 5%, whatever it is, right? So collect from 4% and give it to or spend it for all 135%, isn't it? So let's check that, okay? Achha, still about me, huh? We have not covered this, no? Last time. I am a chartered accountant, okay? My graduate intern from BMCC, Pune. I've done LLB as well later on after my completion of CA. And luckily, I was in a firm for my articleship, which is considered as top 10 firms in India, only for taxes and assets, I mean the tax field as such. That's why 3 years I have done only tax only. That also direct tax, income tax. That's why that kind of, you can say, love or you can say interest I have in the field of taxation. So I have done nothing of audit as such, nothing of accounting, nothing, no vouching, nothing in my articleship days. I did all of that later on to get some extra knowledge or you can say overview after qualifying as a CA. But in my articleship time, I was only into taxation. And that is the reason I was a little bit only into taxation. I should write some articles, some kind of research material, whatever we have to research during our articleship days. So from something like that, and then we used to create some or write some articles. Articles, you understand, no? Something or the other. We should give some kind of opinion or articles. And that I used to publish or I used to send it everywhere. And so my articles are there on Taxman. Some articles are there, over also the Hindu. The Hindu you might have heard of, newspaper. There, Taxman website, Tax Guru, CA, all these websites were there. So I want you to visit, write on this also, one more website.
Tax. So what does that and company stands for?
Which one?
And company. What does that mean?
It is how you represent or show your this firm, usually. That is the nomenclature we use. You can use and company, or you can say that is a group. It is not your about companies act.
Is it about proprietorship or partnership or anything?
Yes. See, you can use and company even for proprietorship. So even I have my own proprietorship, Neeraj Mahajan and company. So it is your choice. You want to use and company or and associates, or you can just use Neeraj Mahajan. I mean, in case of my example, I'm telling you. So that is also valid. So that is the nomenclature we use for proprietorship. It has nothing to do with your companies act when you use. But it is a nomenclature, how we show that. When you say just Sudhir Kepari, maybe people are not aware what you are talking about. So when you say and company, it is about either proprietorship or mainly firm. Mainly used for firm, but. Taxguru.com, you can see your website, okay? Use that. I'll tell you what to do basically. So after classes today, whenever you get time or whenever you are home, check this website. Then one more website. ITAT online.org नहीं आएंगे. ओके वन मोर वेबसाइट आई वाज टेलिंग यू ITAT online.org. ओके फर्स्ट वन विच यू हैव रिटन टैक्स गुरु राइट taxguru.in राइट एंड यू कैन यूज ऑल्सो वन मोर विच आई हैड शोन यू जस्ट नाउ taxman.com आई थिंक इट इज taxman.com इट इज MANN हाँ MANN taxman.com फाइन. नाउ व्हाई आई एम गिविंग ऑल दिस वेबसाइट्स मेनली फॉर दीज थ्री वेबसाइट्स. ओके यू विल बी नाउ अपडेटेड क्वाइट अ लॉट. See, I think I was telling you yesterday also, try to read newspaper as much as possible, at least if not the entire newspaper, you can read at least the finance side, and because it is very much relevant and you can say related to your syllabus, you know. So now when you are doing the subject of tax itself, all these websites will help you to stay updated. There will be now, as of today, there will be many terminologies which you don't understand, but in this next 3.5 months, you will be accustomed, you will be understanding almost everything, whatever will come on their website. Now, whatever case studies or case laws I was telling you, all of that is as such mainly updated over here. iTax Online or even Tax Guru gives lots of articles. Like I told you, when I used to write articles, I used to send it on these websites. So there are obviously, as of today only, there are so many professionals, so many researchers, those are giving some kind of articles or opinions. All that you can, and news mainly related to taxation, that all you can, that is available on these websites free of cost. So on just what we used to do as articles, you know, the daily morning our office used to start at 10 o'clock. First 10-15 minutes, we should just go through our emails. You can subscribe to this website actually. And every morning, they deliver an email. And then just go through these articles. This is very much important. It is like updating your database over here. Because then tomorrow, whenever you are working, you might not have that much of time to research again. Then it should hint you, it should click you somewhere. I have read it somewhere on this website. Then you can go and research. See, Google used to be our last resort. Last resort, you understand? Last option to research. As of today, everyone researches first on Google, but that is not the current, you can say, scenario. First, you should go through all the bare acts, rules, whatever is the authentic source, and then you should go on articles or some other opinions. Okay? So, you can go through all these websites, subscribe to them, and on daily basis, you can be updated with whatever tax changes are happening and news, because that will be important and relevant to you. Okay? So, this practice, if you start as of today, it will obviously help you in your articleship interview as well later on. You know? Yes? Let's go ahead then. We have obviously the entire 100 marks syllabus of taxation into two parts, income tax and GST. Income tax for 60 and GST for 40. So 60-40 ratio you have, but like I said, this takes almost 160 hours and this takes close to 40 to 50 hours. Right? Again, income tax should be mix of both theory and practical. GST mainly right now for your syllabus is mainly theoretical, most of it theoretical, right? Let's go ahead. And one more thing I want to tell you, sorry. Now pay attention. Even your paper number, this is your paper number 4, right? Even this has your MCQs for 30 marks, okay? So again, a good advantage. Again, when I talk about law will be very easy to score. 70 plus is very much possible. But for taxation, you have to really have a good hold on all the chapters, on all the concepts as much as possible. I'm telling you right now, it is not, you can say, compared to other subjects, it is going to be one of the lengthiest subjects. So when I say lengthiest, that means so many concepts will be involved, right? Notes and all, that whatever we'll share that time, you'll understand that, right? But that is the reason. I don't know about any other subject, but taxation is something which you should read or study on daily basis, right? I told you yesterday to create a folders in your laptop or whatever, your mobile, and download first of all the study material of ICAI. First of all, download that. Now, whenever you get time, go through that as well. Whenever you get time after evening, whenever your classes are over, go through our notes also. Reading on continuous basis is important, because when we actually start with the syllabus, it is going to be very, 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 very new things, chapter after another, okay? So that should not happen. That once you're on chapter number 3, you are forgetting something about chapter number 1. That should really not happen. Okay, you have to be very, very careful about that. Okay, and we have in totality of income tax, we have almost 15 chapters. I'll be obviously showing you the syllabus, but it is going to be lengthy. 15 chapters for 60 marks, and 10 chapters of GST for 40 marks. So 25 chapters for 100 marks, right? So that's why I'm telling you, I'm not trying to scare you over here, but it's going to be lengthy syllabus, but very much possible. Okay. Yeah, sorry, फिर से रह गया हूँ. MCQ for 30 marks. So out of this 30 marks, again income tax MCQs will be for 18 marks. Are you understanding?
Yeah.
Even this 30 is bifurcated into
60-40
ratio, right? Out of 100, your 70 is what? Descriptive. 30 is MCQ. So that is the reason even this 30 is distributed in the same ratio of 60 and 40. So out of 30 marks, 60% is 18 marks is for income tax, and your 12 marks will be for GST MCQs. Good question. Passing. It is not individual passing of income tax GST. It is not like that. It is passing out of 100 marks. Okay. So, can I say over here GST out of 40 marks? Is it 28 marks? Descriptive will be there. Yes or no? Out of this 28 marks, you will have 2 questions of practical and remaining will be completely theory. 4 marks, you can say 2 questions of 8 marks and remaining will be theoretical, descriptive writing. Here, apna kitna ho gaya? 40, kitna? 18 na? 32.
60 minus 18.
Karna bhi. 38. Nahi, sorry, kya ho raha hai?
42.
32 kya ho raha hai? 42, sorry. 42 will be your descriptive, right? Out of that, the first question. Itam jabardast. The first question out of that 42 marks will be for 16 marks. That is question number 1. And that they say it is compulsory. They say compulsory. Alag baat, okay? That is different. But that 16 marks question is one question only. But it is merger of all 15 chapters. We call it as total income question. We call it as total income question. When you have a syllabus, obviously you divide into small concepts, okay? And then one single question is based on almost on your entire syllabus. And remaining will be now specific for one particular chapter, one particular concept, and so, right? So that is basically our target. Our target means that 16 marks should also, we should be able to grab those 16 marks as well. When it will be a matter of writing the papers, that time I will say, do not attempt this first question in the first time itself. That means at 2 o'clock, whenever your papers will start, first obviously you should focus on MCQs of these 30 marks. And then remaining of this small questions. And then when the time remains, time will remain obviously, then we will go for this one. Because I don't want you to get stuck with this for 1 hour and 1.5 hour and then there is no time. It is, I think, just like accounting. Whenever I used to be very scared about amalgamation and these CFS, consolidated financial statements, all these concepts you have in accounts. Even there used to be like 16 marks, 20 marks question. And like I'll leave that at last. I'm going to focus on the majority remaining of it, 70 to 80 marks. So first I should focus on that. And whenever whatever time is to remain, then I should try that 16 marks question. Then give it kind of last priority from writing point of view. Because if you get stuck over there, it will be a very big problem. You will not be able to cover remaining of the frequency paper. Understand it here? Got it? Don't get so scared. Small step. What do I believe in? Always first take the first step first. No? There are 1,000 steps to be covered. That journey is, we can complete only by starting the first step. So we start with small basics, and then we will go ahead. Okay, don't worry.
More time
is coming. We have 3.5 months to cover. You'll see what is all is happening. Hai na? In this summer, we'll all get tanned. Hai na? We'll all get all 5-6 kgs, we'll all reduce. There will be sleep deprivation. And what do you call this? Under eye circle? Dark circles. Okay, black hole. अभी डार्क सर्कल ब्लैक होल ही हो जाएंगे ना. ऑल दैट विल बी देयर अगेन योर नेक्स्ट 3 मंथ्स देन टू यू नो अगेन द स्टडीज विल ऑलवेज कंटिन्यू. हां, व्हाट गोस इन स्लीप डजंट गो इन ओनली नो दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम. सो ऑल दीस थिंग्स विल बी देयर. योर 300 पेजेस आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट विल बी फिल्ड, है ना. सो इट विल बी. बट व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग यू इज व्हेन यू विल बी ऑन द 300th पेज इन योर नोटबुक, यू शुड ऑल्सो स्टिल रिमेंबर फर्स्ट चैप्टर व्हाट यू हैव रिटन. दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, है ना. इट इज लाइक अ बिग स्टोरी व्हिच लाइक अ व्हाट डू यू कॉल इट एज ग्रंथ को क्या बोलते हैं? ग्रंथ को क्या बोलते हैं इंग्लिश में? मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट. अच्छा, मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट पक्का. ठीक है मैनुस्क्रिप्ट वी आर गोइंग टू राइट अ वेरी बिग मैनुस्क्रिप्ट ठीक है सो इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेरी बिग स्टोरी सो इट्स अ लॉन्ग जर्नी राइट सो यस वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टैक्स बच्चों राइट लिटिल बिट व्हाई वी नीड टैक्स एंड हाउ एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट सो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज टेकिंग टैक्सेस फ्रॉम द पब्लिक फॉर द पब्लिक अगेन इट इज लाइक टेलिंग समबडी कंपल्सरी आई एम टेकिंग फ्रॉम यू बट फॉर योर बेनिफिट लाइक अरे व्हाट इज दिस है ना आई एम टेकिंग फ्रॉम यू कंपल्सरी बट इट इज फॉर योर बेनिफिट Is it true? But actually, it is for benefit of all, and it should be taken from all. But that is what again we are going to see the differences, you know, ki, that we cannot take from all, or also at times we are also taking from all. Both of that is going to happen, right? So, but taking from the public for the public by an particular administration. Okay, dear. So, it's like one of the earliest you can say discussions of taxation. What is here in this example, whatever. Whatever it is written over here, what do you want to call it? Example, okay? It was only for the good of his subjects. Kaun sa subject? Costing accounts? Nahi na? For the public at large. Haan, public. People, yes. We the people. Hai na? That he collected taxes from them. Abhi he kaun ho gaya bachcho? The ruler. Chale. Good. Authority, king. Correct. In Indian history, we don't have queens over. Jhansi. One, only one? Holkar. I love a Holkar. Yeah, but that is also recent. Middle no, thousands of there was one, no? Sultas. Razia Sultas. But again, issue means anyways, but yeah, but we don't have that kind of history. In Queen, I mean not Queen, yeah, UK, yeah. Queen only, no, right? Yeah. They that goes through their own female descendants also. So they can become queen as well. Anyways. So it was only for the good. उनके बेनिफिट के लिए ऑफ द पीपल दैट ही कलेक्टेड टैक्सेस फ्रॉम देम देमसेल्फ फॉर देयर ओन गुड कलेक्ट फ्रॉम देम नाइस कॉन्सेप्ट नो इफ यू टेल योर यंगर ब्रदर और सिस्टर यू नो इफ यू ऑल यू हैव यंगर ब्रदर एंड सिस्टर है ना आई एम टेकिंग योर चॉकलेट फॉर योर ओन गुड सो दैट यू डोंट गेट हैवी यू डोंट हैव डायबिटीज योर टीथ विल बी गुड है ना विल यू एक्चुअली लाइक इट बिल्कुल नहीं अरे एक है आई विल चेक आई विल सी व्हाट आई हैव टू डू नो यू डोंट टेल मी बट नो We live in a society, na yaar, isn't it, guys? We live in a society, and when you say society, there has to be some rules and conditions. Haan ya na? There has to be some rules. So to maintain a kind of that society decorum, to be in a part of society, we are so afraid, no? We are so afraid. Baju wali aunty kya kahegi? What will char log kya kahenge? What will people say and all of that? What will society say? We have to live in a society. Such a big statement, hai na? But again, talking about earlier times also, so in that society, to maintain the society and to regulate it, the ruler had to collect the taxes for their own benefit, isn't it? Just as, wow, check the example. Just as the sun draws what? Moisture. Is it like, what was that? Water cycle. This is what we learned, no? Water cycle. Sun takes what? Water from earth. Whatever. It takes me, it doesn't go outside the in space, okay, obviously. But again, it gives back, isn't it? So it takes, we have 70% water and then it again gives everywhere, no? So from earth, to give it back a thousandfold, wow. That is, whatever it is drawing, it is again giving it back, but evenly as such, you know? So wherever it is required, whatever the, it is obviously an old saying or whatever rhyme or whatever you want to say, you know? There was no science as such over there that time. So just understand, now you will say, hey, now you know better, you know? That was written by who? Kalidas. In old, you can say whatever. How old? Illogizing, whatever. That means, or you can say appreciating, or you can say in the compliment of this particular king, whatever it is. That means, that time, the kind of you can say justification of tax was given, that you require tax, you know? That is, she's researching. Fine. Pay attention. Next one. No government. Now we are not talking of the ruler and the king. Now we are talking of the government, a system, you know, proper system. Even whenever we are talking of monarchy and kings and queens, but still, that is for the namesake now. The actual government or you can say mechanism is different now. Even in Japan, we give respect. King is over there like God. In Japan, like king is next to God over there. But admission is someone else, no? Isn't it? So we need that system. So no government can exist without taxation. this money must necessarily be levied. Levied. Okay. I'm going to write it over here. Levy. L-E-V-I. Levy means what?
Enforce.
Okay.
Impose.
Enforce. Or say charge. Okay. It should be charged on a particular person. Okay. Levy. On the people. It must be. And the grand art consists of levying so as not to
oppress.
What do you mean by oppress? पूरा का पूरा चॉकलेट नहीं देना. ओके हाँ पूरा का पूरा चॉकलेट नहीं लेना. एंटायर चॉकलेट नॉट टू बी टेकन. 100% चॉकलेट. ऑप्रेस ओके नॉर्मल मीनिंग इन्फीरियर. ओके मीन एनीथिंग एल्स एनीबडी एल्स कैन आई से बुली इन अ वे बुली बुली यू अंडरस्टैंड बीइंग यू कैन से वेरी मच मीन और यू कैन से injustice in a way, being oppressed, that means you are getting a person work for 10-12 hours and paying him salary for 4-6 hours only, and I'm not giving proper nutrition, food, not giving him services, whatever is due, that is being oppressed. Like for example, like farmers in India during British rule, they were kind of oppressed, or we people of India under foreign rule were kind of oppressed, understanding today also by government, right? So basically when you are controlled in a very wrong way by the majority or someone controller, that is being oppressed. Okay. Okay. There is also some other word suppressed, oppressed. Suppress is to surpass somebody. Go ahead. Suppress. Correct. Oppress is again in the kind of oppression. It is not operation. It is oppression. That means again the majority is bullying the minority. That you can understand. But again in the not for the benefit of minority. That means there is some kind of disadvantage to the minority that you have to understand. Yes. Okay.
For personal benefits.
Own benefits. Yeah. Again, majority doing something in the company for their own benefit, which is not in the benefit of minority. That's how. Okay. Okay, here, everybody. Usually, your workers in factory, they were getting oppressed. That is the reason we got the act. Which one?
Labor laws.
Labor laws we have and factories act. I think 1948 something it is. Whatever it is. Factories Act also. So now, what do you think would be the purpose of Factories Act? What do you think? What is the purpose of Factories Act? I mean, bringing this act. Especially in 1948, it was just after independence.
Isn't there any more factories like
ethical? Very good, very good. There was no mechanism. There was no mechanism or because a system of how to run factories. Or what should be there or what should not be there in factories. Defining working hours. There should be a place to work. There may be a uniform. What about safety of the workers who are working in a very dangerous, you can say, industry? Health, canteen, ventilation, you can say hygiene, toilets and all of that. Not all is discussed or you can say properly imposed in Factories Act. Now if Factories Act was not there, if Factories Act was not there, then what? Every person was free to do anyhow, no?
No proper system.
That means you can make 10 people work in a very small room also without ventilation. That is again operation only, no?
Giving a framework.
Huh?
Giving a framework.
So that's why the act is giving you a framework. What should be done, what should not be done. Then we talk about pollution also. There should be again your exhaust system, again your waste management system around the factory. All that is discussed. And for that you require a law. Without law, people are not going to listen. And without law, there is no uniformity also, no? There are only a handful of persons who are going to do something better than what is required. But majority requires some law. Apart from that, otherwise, nobody is going to follow. Hena, when your mama is not standing on the signal, Hena, when there are no cameras on the signal, then what? Do we agree? Do we follow the rules, regulations? No. It is our rule. Hena. Even if it is showing red signal, still go ahead. Hena. So, it obviously, there has to be first of all some law, and then the other part is about implementation of law. You might have heard, I am not quite sure, GST. The law is quite good. What is the problem? Ask any chartered accountant or ask any tax professional. Literally, last month they had to do a protest, all India protest. What is this system? There is no OTP coming, there is no login happening, there is nothing happening, we are unable to file only. Website crashing all the time. Then you are not even extending the due dates. Such a pathetic situation. I think that, who is that Bajaj, Rahul Bajaj?
Raju Bajaj.
उनका सन इज राहुल बजाज और राजीव बजाज, राजीव बजाज. इवन ही हैड क्रिटिसाइज्ड 2-3 years back itself that your GST idea is good but implementation is pathetic. When you have proper planning, he had used this nice word. When you have proper planning, the implementation should be like a hot knife cutting through butter. It should be that smooth. You don't have planning, you just wanted to implement, you just wanted to take the credit and you put it in place. What is happening over here? All chaos. And so just law is not important. Implementation of law is also equally important. Isn't it? Otherwise, kya fayda? What is the use of just having a law without implementation? You know? Anyways. So again, you're talking about art is that he should not levy so that it looks like an operation. You know, when we say, when you're earning 100 rupees and you take 100 rupees as tax, that is obviously operation. Like any, so you should take only that much, which should not feel like a operation, but it should look like a necessity as well. You know, so there should be a kind of a nice balance between both of these, taxpayer and the tax collector, or you can say government, isn't it? Right? And these are obviously your quite old, you can say examples, or you can say narration about taxation. Hai na? Ye kitna aaya iska time period?
1861.
Abhi gayi hai?
Nahi
nahi.
5th
century. 5th century. AD mein, aaj AD you said what?
1861
aise dikha hai. 5th
century
is so obvious.
1861.
Nahi theek hai, it's okay. 5th century. 5th century maan. AD tha wo, haan. बड़े आगे, लेट्स गो अहेड. सो दीज आर अगेन योर ओल्ड, यू कैन से डिस्कशन ऑफ टैक्सेस. ओके, पे अटेंशन. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट मॉडर्न वंस, द प्रैक्टिकल वंस एज ऑफ टुडे. है ना? Now, what do we usually say when you are able to drive your two-wheeler in Pune? You know, you can drive your two-wheeler anywhere in the world. You know, it is like that. I mean, that is kind of roads and all kind of system we have here. So, if you are able to do something, drive two-wheeler in Pune, you can drive anywhere, isn't it? And honestly, like if at all you can handle the traffic of Bangalore, then you can handle the traffic of anywhere in the world. It is like that, you know. There should be, people are saying there should be some separate transport system from Bangalore airport to Bangalore city. It is that, you can say, far and away from city. I mean, one day I had gone from city to airport. That cab took like minimum 1,000 rupees. Minimum 1,000 rupees from city to airport. And 1 hour journey.
Two and a half hours during peak time. That is possible.
That I don't know. But I reached in one and a half hour something luckily that day. But difficult. Anyways.
Hyderabad,
they made a very long flyover. Very long flyover. So you reach now. But it is far. But it's a good, well, that flyover is quite one way kind of. Anyways, but talking of practical situation of taxes of today. So again, let me tell you, if you learn income tax of India, you can learn again any tax of anywhere in the world. It is one of the most complex, you can say, acts available as of today. Okay. So the hardest thing in the world to understand is the income tax, said by famous. He's okay with physics and giving all the new things, but he was not so even comfortable with income. So there's also one more saying actually. There are only two things certain in life. There are only two things confirmed, guaranteed, certain in life. One is death, another is taxes. So these two things you cannot avoid as such in your life. Right, Delia? Understood? Yeah? So yes, this will be, you will be feeling this, that feeling, that hardest thing to understand at times is income tax. See, one thing, if I honestly say whatever income tax act we are going to learn, you know, I don't want the same thing happening, what is happening right now in other laws also in our syllabus, you know, in law paper too. We are learning almost 150, 120 years old law. Okay? They may be or may not be that much directly practical or applicable as of today, that is different. But at least, hopefully, I mean, luckily, they changed your company's act. In time, from 1956 to now, 2013, whatever we are doing as per time, as per the requirement. This, see, pay attention, I mean, it is now, you will be able to understand now. Companies Act directly doesn't affect the revenue of the government. Are you understanding? Companies Act or the law doesn't affect the revenue of the government, isn't it? But Income Tax Act or your GST is affecting the revenue of the government. So it is a very tricky business, changing the law, which is giving revenue to the government and keeping balance between obviously the taxpayer and the government, isn't it? But having said that, it was almost in 2008-10 around when I had started my articleship actually that time, that we were discussing DTC, direct tax code. So the replacement of income tax at 1961 to direct tax code, that was in plans since 2008 and 2010. Okay, when again that and this BJP government came, then they were talking about banking transaction tax, replace 1% entire
1% on banking transaction.
Replace entire income tax with just tax on all the banking transaction. That means there should be no cash only in the system. All transaction, even if it is 1 rupee, 10 rupee, 100 rupees, everything to bank. Now whatever money is coming in your bank, there will be certain kind of percentage of tax on that. No income tax. Again, it was not that foolproof concept as such. It didn't happen. It is not going to happen also. So don't worry. We are safe with our knowledge of income tax. So this is almost next to impossible. But again, this should come. Now again, why this is also not coming? The new Income Tax Act is not coming. Because this new government has already done lots of experiments. Let it be about black money, demonetization, GST. So they have done lots of radical changes in the country. And they are also burning, they have burnt their hands. Again, farm bill and all of that. So they are making changes, but some of them are backfiring. So again, in the same government, changing the two most important laws in the country, that I think is again not going to happen so soon. Committees on committees have sat and given DTC. In fact, when I was doing articleship, there was a law available on DTC. Even today, that law is available, but it is just under discussion stage. It has been almost a decade now. Again, they will form another committee. Again, some committee will give some kind of recommendation what kind of law should be there. But maybe, hopefully, in your professional life, when you will become chartered accountants, maybe you will be able to see the new law for direct taxes as well. But as of today, still we have to deal with 1961 Act. Fine till here? So, 1961 till 2021, 60 years. Barabar na, correct? 60 years. Were there changes or not in the Act or law? Thousands of changes. Thousands of changes. And very, it's already, it is a tricky law. So thousands of changes have happened since 1961 till 2021. It keeps on happening in between whenever Nirmala madam wakes up, okay, she gets a fit, no, na? And then like, okay, let's change this, okay, let's make life uneasy, na? That's kuch, aaj kuch tufani karta hai. And notification, na? Change in law, beech mein. Whenever there is some kind of economy is going down, again, press conference, let us do something, na? Let us give some kind of boost somewhere. Madam can do anything. Anyways, but basically changes were happening since quite a long time, and then you have to, that is the reason I'm telling you this law is very, very dynamic. It is more dynamic even than your Companies Act. Companies Act, at least you don't have that much of changes. Income Tax Act, there can be any changes. GST 24/7, there can be changes. GST is like on another level only. But luckily for you, it is still on a very surface based only. I mean, it is very basic right now, not that in too much in depth. Let's go ahead. Yeah. Obviously, taxes are what, bachcho? A very important part of revenue. What do you mean by the term revenue? Yes, earnings, incomes, you can say. You know? When you do revenue versus capital, that is in different contexts. When I talk about revenue, that is you are talking about income of the government, right? GOI, that is Government of India. Finally, everybody, right? For what purpose? This is all basics here. Public spending. We have learned that in what, economics? Maybe 9th, 10th standard. What do you used to have? Civics something, na? Civics you used to have?
Civics and economics.
Civics and economics. Public spending, infrastructure, hospital, dam. What do you have? Electricity, power station, what not, schools, you know? Infrastructure, building, national defense, very important, no? Communication and defense is obviously the most important. And giving subsidies. Some of the other sectors, they have always, you can say, boosting. Did you check, you were there, I think, on budget, the recent budget which happened? Did you watch the budget?
Yes,
you were there, huh? Live, you were there for 2 hours. Anybody of you? Budget speech? I can tell you in short that budget speech, every budget speech starts with certain objects. Every budget speech. And in this coming, upcoming financial year, we have certain sectors or they have, you can say, a theme. I can say theme also. It is based on a particular theme. That means, let us say, youth employment. Again, I'm giving you youth welfare and youth employment, and then again even your elderly people. That can be a theme. So for elderly people, they are giving some benefits in medicines, or you can say some deductions. Some amount is still not taxable for, you can say, senior citizens. But again, for, you can say, youth or employer, you can say, for the purpose of employment, again, they are giving some kind of benefits over there. So it depends what kind of theme the government is following for the coming financial year. So every budget speech starts with that. Keep that in mind, okay? So when you're talking about the purposes, no, it is obviously pre-decided in advance. Now you understand the budget usually comes on 1st February. It is just the presentation. I think it was the first budget which was read out through a tab. It was the first budget. Uske pehle, I mean, always you had that that briefcase. Every finance minister used to show a briefcase, open the briefcase, then papers and read out through the tangible, or you can say physical papers as such. Read out. This was the first budget when madam was reading through a tab. And something good changed, nice also. Right? So themes are, you can say, already pre-decided. So on 1st February, the budget is there. It has just been presented. I don't know, you might be aware or not. I think in the last 1 month or last 15 days, the entire department is closed. You cannot go out. That whatever office or area, wherever the budget is going to be printed or you can say finalized, it has mobile jammers. That means you cannot connect with outside world. Or even if you want to connect with your family, you have again some secured system and all of that. So all those people are locked for the last 15 days over there only. And again, there is some kind of famous halwa ceremony, halwa. The finance minister goes over there in that department wherever the budget is beginning finalized, and she or whatever he, they help in making of the halwa, sweets over there. And they distribute sweets just before presentation of budget. That ceremony is also always there. I mean, also there. It is a kind of a custom. So you understand this is happening in the month of January, etc. Hai na? The budget is almost getting finalized, but pre-budget, in the months of September, October, the finance minister and the department and the team, etc., everyone, they are in lots of talks and discussion with your chambers of commerce and industrialists and people at large, that what are expectations, how is this financial year going on, what do you expect in the next financial year, this dialogue and discussion goes on, almost 4-5 months before the budget, and that is how they understand and decide the theme. And that is how the changes are happening. So it is not something is happening on one single day. There's a big process behind it. So now this budget is given. Now you understand hardly again after 6 months, again the same thing will happen for the next financial year. The finance minister and the department will become busy after September, October, learning for the next financial year what is to be done. Understanding the year? Yes. So you think budget affects the country?
Yes, very much.
Obviously. Obviously. So this such an important work we are understanding over, isn't it? So there will be mainly, when you divide or you can say talk about taxes, there will be mainly two types of taxes, direct taxes and indirect taxes. Fine till here? Yes? We will discuss a little bit of basics of that. Okay. So old regime, you understand?
System.
System, correct. System, mechanism. Now please understand, even in law I tell you, always focus on vocabulary. So whenever in class you hear a new word, you can ask me later or you can ask me that time itself, but please enhance your vocabulary. If you did not know, write down all the words. There is no embarrassment or shame in learning new word. There is no problem. Anna? Yes? Finally, so old regime, what we were completely dependent on. We had excise. Anna? Excise duty. We had service tax, right? We had VAT, that is value added tax, right till here? Now you'll see, obviously you have something central, not central mall, okay? Then over here we have state, right? Yes or no? If I just have to discuss, how do you think bachcho a country is made? You will ask me what kind of question is this? Country is made, that means you have a this kind of location and then you divide into states. This is just an example, no? Or you already had states and then you joined them in a country. Did you understand my point of view?
Yes.
Right. So is it a mixture that states are coming together to form a country? Like example, I don't know, you might have heard about, there are so many small tribes. Have you heard of tribes? In jungles also, I mean, jungles means you can see lots of rural area. In old, you can say civilization also. There are lots of small tribes. And all those tribes, when they come together, they become a kind of a big, you can say, community. It is something like that. When small, you can say, states are coming together, they want to be represented by one single country. Again, right? And similarly, it can be also opposite, that there is one already big land or big, you can say, area, and now they divide that area into smaller, or you can say, states. In India also, we have done as per what? You can say, it was joining of the states, as well as the states, you can say, boundary as such, you define as per your languages, I think, isn't it? So, till where or till what location the, you can say, the people are of the same culture and language, that is also we have decided the borders, or you can say, geographical areas. And the stitching of our entire states, we obviously give credit to Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, you know, that he bought all the princely states, all the different rulers, whatever it is, and then we are now properly into a country, isn't it? Yeah. So, now tell me, Bachcho, in that case, who is important? The state is important or the country is important? The correct answer is both. Yeah, that is the correct answer. Both are important. Okay? Both are equally as such important. But our democracy, or you can say our constitution, or you can say this system is such that, yeah, there are certain, you can say, advantages or more power given to the center compared to states. There are still certain, you can say, regulations which the state cannot do without approval of the center. But center can do everything in any state as such, isn't it? But these things, what do you think it will be? Where it will be? Will it, where all these things will be given? Where this all things will be discussed? Who is allowed what and all of that? Will center is allowed what? State is allowed what? What can they do? What they cannot do? Where? How is the parliament? It is very well defined. Everything is very well defined in constitution. So you can also imagine the importance of this document, or you can say legal document, the supreme document of India, constitution. It is describing, defining the powers, authorities, duties, responsibility, everything of the center as well as state. And the, you can say, nice, you can say, friendship between both these people, how that can sustain. It is like a partnership. Isn't it? Have you heard of partnership? You have done anything in foundation also? A partnership cannot sustain without deed. Partnership deed. Any kind of problems you might not see right now, but in future, but even if that is agreed upon, or you can say clarified in between, in the advance itself, then there is no issue, because then you are following the deed. And so what kind of issues might arise between center and state? All that obviously would have been taken into picture. And then this constitution is made so that it is hand in hand. Both of them are jolly together. Again, are you understanding till here? Right? So in GST also, we are going to later on understand that why it was so difficult to implement GST as well that time. I mean, in the recent years. You know? Okay till here. So all these things, what center is allowed, it should do, what state is allowed, what it should do, and all of that, that is defined in, given in constitution. We will learn that again in income tax when we go a little bit ahead. So, now talking about taxes also. There are again two types of, we have two hierarchy system we have. We have center, that is union, and then we have state. Again, right? So they are given also authority, center, to manage, they have entire authority for the entire country. State has jurisdiction only for that particular state. No. Can Maharashtra tell Karnataka, oh, your police uniform is matching with us, change it. Can they tell that? No. Your VAT is of same rate with us, change it. Can they tell that? No. Karnataka only, hey, why? What is happening over here? You don't have any jurisdiction over here. But center, where it has authority, it can do anything in any of the kind of states. Isn't it, Bachcho? So here we are discussing a little bit of jurisdiction as well. So again, talking about taxes. So some taxes are, you can say, the power or authority is given to the center. And some, you can say, again, taxes, or you can say authority is given to the state. And Bachcho, are you understanding here? Now you tell me, pay attention now. If this was not there, if VAT or that state tax was not there, what do you think would be the implication or problem? State will be completely begging to the center. The state will be begging to the center. And obviously in India, you are very well aware, as of Maharashtra also right now. We don't have same government in state as well as in center, isn't it? It is a coalition government here in state, and we have some different party in the center. Now you think in that case center is going to help such kind of states? Obviously not. Hai na? So this problem might be there. So in that case, if the state doesn't have its own autonomy, or you can say independence, it will be completely dependent on the center for its own development, isn't it? Right? And obviously some states are very important to the center. If the finance capital of India is not going to cooperate with the center, what the center is going to do? I'm just giving you examples, you know. So both of them should have their own little bit of independence. Are you understanding? That is the reason we gave also the right to levy VAT to the state departments, isn't it? Or state government, sorry. Right, Ilya? Now, are you understanding the problem or fight for implementation of GST now?
Yes.
Little bit. In GST, it is once as such one single tax. So obviously, what do you think the state will be asking? They won't even want, they want even their own share or not. They were like, we were having this or not, VAT. We were having our own independence VAT. What about that? Are we going to sacrifice on that? No, no, no. We want that share also.
GST.
That's, that is the reason we have both the taxes, no? Central as well as states. That is what we are going to learn. But you are here, I hope you are understanding the fight between the state and the center. We want our independence also. We want our regular, and they don't want any, you can say, sacrifice also. Now again, I am giving the example. Example, let us say if a particular state was earning, pay attention, if a particular state was earning 1000 crore in taxes, VAT. Okay, particular state was earning, or you can say getting 1000 crore as VAT tax. Now by implementation of GST, what are they going to claim, or what are they going to have a point of view that we want this? What about a 1000 crores? Today, through GST, we are only earning, let us say, 800 crores. What about our deficit? It can be otherwise also. Because you are going to have a uniform as a tax structure, it can be opposite also. Some state might be getting some higher share also in tax. That is also much, very much possible. But the big brother, I mean the person who was earning so much before, he is obviously not going to be happy about it, no? So again, that kind of adjustment between the state, Arey Baba, theek hai, I'll give you, don't worry, we'll compensate that. So again, that, all these things, they take time to implement, no? Are you understanding? So that fight was going on. Anyways, so excise is levied on
production.
One interesting case, let me tell you, I think I discussed somewhere in class. Parachute oil. Have you seen in your home? That nice dark blue, indigo blue, you know? ऐसे कुछ तो बॉटल है समथिंग अंडरस्टैंड ठीक है जो भी है अजीम पैराशूट ऑयल है ना बच्चों राइट व्हाट डू वी यूज इट फॉर ऑयलिंग हेयर ऑब्वियसली हेयर नाइस नाइस हीरोइंस दे शो है ना विद लॉट्स ऑफ कलर एंड विग दे आर वेयरिंग माइट बी आई डोंट नो बट एकदम वॉट एवर है ना एटलीस्ट इन द ओल्ड कमर्शियल और कैसे एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स है ना बच्चों राइट यू कंपेयर आई मीन इफ यू स्टिल हैव एट योर होम पैराशूट ऑयल यू कैन आस्क You can take photos, you know, of the bottle I'm talking about. You know, this is oil as such. What does, who's the, this manufacturer, Marico, na?
Yes.
Name. Marico. Marico, you know. Marico. HUL has eaten everything that is different. There are still small, small brands, or you can say other brands remaining. Yeah, Marico. You know what did Marico say? This parachute oil is a cooking oil. It is a cooking oil. What oil we use at home? Sunflower or groundnut or whatever, hai na? It is just the same cooking oil, parachute oil. The bottle which they are selling, that blue color, okay? They might show in earlier advertisements, whatever. Now, what did they say? This is, pay attention, this is a 100% coconut oil. It is coconut, no? It is 100% coconut oil. And that was their intention, that we want to manufacture 100% pure coconut oil. Now that is our not that is not our problem. That people will do malish with that, massage with that, or put in their hair, or put in the whatever cooking oil. Our intention was to put no, don't imagine any things, right? But mainly they are saying that it is an edible oil. It is an edible oil. Hayana. Okay, Dalia. What people do with it, that is not our concern, isn't it? Now you understand, Pacho, pay attention. People will use it on hair, okay? Can I say it is a cosmetic product in that case? Pay attention, everybody. Cosmetic, yes or no? If it is, if a particular oil is to be used as a hair oil, it becomes cosmetic. And if an oil, again same thing, is to be used as a cooking oil, it is obviously edible. Yes? Very good. Now in that case, just tell me that, what is a necessity in the market, or can say people at large? What will be the necessity? Cooking oil or cosmetic oil?
Cooking oil.
Cooking oil. Obviously. Again. Now when you talk about again taxes, that time excise duty was there. Okay? And excise duty is on production, or you can say manufacturing of certain goods as such. Now taxes will be lower on the necessity or cosmetic?
Necessity.
On the necessity, the taxes will be lower, and cosmetic it will be higher. Again, obviously common sense, right? Till here, simple till here. So what did Marico say? What kind of oil is this?
Cooking.
What is the impact of that? Lower tax, obviously. Lower tax, higher na. Hare higher na. Pandora is enjoying over there, hai na? Lower tax. Now you again imagine a company like Marico with a brand like Parachute Oil, such a big brand, with revenue in thousands of crores of rupees. Again, I'm just giving you an example. Let us say, if excise duty over here, again, this is just an example, 10% in cosmetic, right? And if it is edible or cooking oil, it is just 5%, again, just for the sake of example, okay? Or nil also for that matter, whatever it is again a food item. Because it is edible, it is food item. Or you can say nil also, whatever. Will that not impact the company on a very large scale?
Yes.
If the revenue itself is in thousands of crores of rupees for that particular product, and you're reducing that tax, and even if you reduce by 1% single, it is going to make a very big impact on the profitability. Everything, or rather, everything, their valuation, everything. Are you understanding till here? And this is happening because of what? I mean, taxes, study of taxes, or you can say the way of learning or understanding and interpreting and using that taxes. There was, let us say, kind of loophole or whatever it might be. Whatever it might be. So even the department said, okay, it is cooking oil, fine. But in your advertisement, you're showing women with nice long hair and black or whatever color of hair, and then you're showing it is such a nice oil. But that is not our problem. Na. We are creating or manufacturing 100% coconut oil. So people use it for whatever purpose. We have made it as a cooking oil. Even today, you will be surprised. If at all you have, let us say, two brands of hair oil at your home, if at all. And one of them is Parachute. Okay? On that bottle, you have lots of description given over there, details and all of that. Right? And Parachute oil, you know, what are you going to see? You might have something like this, energy. Have you seen of that? Energy,
yeah.
Kcal,
yeah.
Protein, fats, sugar, that whatever it is. That details, both are the green one. Yeah, that is there, right? But that is food items pe hai.
Food items
pe
hai, baaki hair oils pe
nahi aayega, correct. So on Parachute oil, you can see all these details, which are usually given where on food items. If you check immediately, any other brand, if at all you'll have at home, it will not have these details. Obviously not. Because that is not a food item. I understand earlier, it is a cosmetic item, and other details, whatever might be the chemicals and this and all of that, that details might be given over there. I understand earlier, right? So this will definitely, this makes study itself of the taxes, this makes lots of impact. Now you tell me, Bachchu, when I said excise is levied on production. What do you mean by this word, Bachchu, production? What do you think?
Manufacturing.
Very good. Manufacturing, all right, yes. And what do you do in the process of manufacturing?
Converting raw materials to finished products.
Very good. Yeah, but very simple question and hopefully simple answer. Conversion. Correct? Eh? Yes or no? Correct, Elio? When you have tea, and whenever you are to drink tea, you are using tea. Let us say whatever tea powder, isn't it? Yes or no? And that tea powder is coming at your place or whatever you are buying from the package. You know? Did that tea as such go through some kind of manufacturing process?
Yes.
Right? Yes. The tea plant gave you tea
leaves.
Like any. And then you are getting converted into tea powder or whatever you are going to use it. Again, yes or no? So even if you are just saying tea, the famous name as such or the nomenclature is tea. Again, there is obviously still a, you can say, change from tea plant to tea powder. This entire process will be still manufacturing. Yes or no? Are you understand till here? Everyone okay till here? Yes? If I give you another example, lots of examples here, don't worry. Let us say, shall I write down here? Water, pay attention. What is it scientific nomenclature?
H2O.
Let me write down this one. H2O barabar hai, correct hai? Yes or no?
Yes.
What about ice? Ice.
H2O.
Also H2O? Yes or no?
Yes.
Ice. But again, if you are converting water into ice, is this manufacturing? Why?
It undergoes a certain process.
Okay.
Processing is
required.
Direct material. Huh? Direct material. Water is there in both places. What are you putting in water to make ice? Nothing, no? Using water only. This is also water only, I said, but solid state is changing.
Processing is a process.
Because process. Okay, I mean, anything, any other answer? One word which will or should come into your mind, and as a study also, if not right now, that is okay. When you say manufacturing,
changes of form.
Yes, change. There is a conversion. This word should come in your mind. Sorry, conversion, or the word is transformation. Pay attention. Transformation. Pay attention. Okay. That means whatever was your input and whatever is your output as such, there has to be some kind of difference. When I say water and then water only, and there is no change as such, right? There has to be some kind of transformation. Now, it can be a physical transformation, it can be just nomenclature or name, that's it. But there has to be some kind of change in the input and the output. Process will obviously be involved. I understand that the process will still be involved. Okay, tell you. So, in what is, you can say, production. Okay, exercise is levied on production. You said production is manufacturing. And actually, what is manufacturing? Is transformation or change. Now there are two important things, Bachcho. How do we confirm there is transformation or conversion or change or not? Now pay attention. Again, for the sake of example, let me tell you. Pay attention. Rajasthan as such is famous for what? Forts. Forts and all. And those forts and all, they are made from what?
Stones.
Are you aware or not? Stones, Rajasthan. Anna? Yeah. Can I tell you? Are you aware or not? Rajasthan is famous for stones. Marbles. Marble is same thing. Right. Yes? Now where do you get the stones? By mining. Correct? Very good. Yeah. Right, tell you? Again, lots of happenings, political things happen in this mining also. You get a license and all of that you can mine from a particular area. Look, mainly, you don't go underground for that. You are mining the particular hills. Yeah. You're going on mountains hills, and then you are
hills.
Yeah, you're getting it from there. Barabar hai. Now marble is also a stone, let us say. Okay, marble is also obviously a stone. Marble, you call it as granite, other one granite, whatever else, okay? Italian marbles and this and that, all that shiny things you have. But when I talk about the property in it, property, the stone in the hill and the stone which may be again, you can say laid down as such, it is stone only, no? It is stone only, yes or no? Again, so converted from that hill wala stone to that stone in your house, whatever granite or marble you're putting in, again, is that manufacturing?
Yes. That is conversion.
It will be same thing. It is either production or not production.
Yes.
At least in tea, from tea plants, leaves and powder. Here, it is stone over there. You get big blocks. I don't know if you have seen or not.
Yeah.
You get big blocks of stone. I mean, obviously you remove a big stone from a hill. And that stone goes into your industry, or you can say factory. And you know what happens over there? I have gone actually to purchase stone. That's what I'm telling you.
They crush the stone. No, they don't crush
it.
Crush slabs of that.
Yes. They will cut this. What do you say? Crush. Then what do you want? Powder? Stone powder you want?
Larger.
You want talcum? Talcum.
Larger the slab, more
will be
the price of
that. Means you get entire shade or design. There are big blocks of stone. I mean, one stone might fit only in one truck. That kind of big, you can say, stone. Obviously, it is it a, you'll get a square, proper, nice rectangle, stone from the hill. No, it will be in the, any kind of shape, right? Any kind of ada teda shape, it will be there, right? Something like this. Imagine this is very big, okay? Like tons, right? Then it comes to a factory, cutting factory, okay? Cutting factory. And it is put in the center as such of that. There is a big, you can say, structure. Two parallel, you can say, bars are there over there, and it's holding that particular stone. And continuously on the top of it, line of, stream of water is continuously dropping. Stream of water. Because of friction. Friction, correct. Yes, I mean, it will heat up or it will die only. I mean, it will be, that blade has to be changed. The blade has to be changed. But because of friction, entire machinery may collapse. Right, so continuously that stream of water is being, put on that stone, and that specifically on that blade. And then there are blades chopping the entire big stone. So obviously now, if you can imagine, if I start chopping from you as such, you know, are you understanding it, Leo? Now this part is going to go waste. This is not a marble, na, the last one. It is not a slab. Are you understanding? Even this is not a slab. It is a wastage, in fact. Just the central one, which are properly being cut. That is what can be used. Are you understanding? Then we properly give it a shape. No. Are you understanding? It is properly cut and then you are giving it the shape. Are you understanding it, Leo? Now this process is a production or not, or manufacturing or not. Again, this matter was litigated. All these matters I am talking right now, that you can, I told you about parachute oil, about this stone, they are all litigated matters, right? So this matter also went to the court. And court said what? We have to rely on certain things. Pay attention now. You have to rely on certain things to understand whether this is production, manufacturing, transformation or not. Okay, and then they kind of devised or put into place kind of two tests. If these two tests are satisfied, then we say yes, it is a manufacturing, or you can say production. Are you understanding it here? And those two tests are, one is name test, okay, and another is use test. Okay. Now when I say name test, that means the input and the output, whether they have different names or not. But you don't.
In this case.
But say it is a stone, and then you are polishing it, grinding it, you are applying some process on that, right? And the use of it. The stone which you bring out from the hill. Can you put it in your home as showpiece and no tiles at all? Why? Because I have that stone. No. I have that stone, enter on the slab, entirely, I'll just show it. No slab, and then no tiles in the home. Why? I have stone. No. Will it be okay? No, we call it as tiles or flooring or something. The stone, and then removing from that stone into using a properly polished and whatever cut and all of that. So that is also going to take, there is a change. Okay, marble, granite, or whatever you want to call it, right? And obviously the use, you know? The stone is of no use to us. What is useful is like marbles and properly cut. Just throw it from there, no? The people, on your neighbor, you know? Always scare your neighbor. I have a big stone, I'll just bring your JC from there and throw it on your head, you know? Swing it directly, you know? Your entire home is demolished. Take my stone, take my tiles, you know? Similarly, about that water example I was telling you, no? What I was telling you about, hai na? Again, water and ice as such, they have different names, obviously, isn't it? And different use also or not. Obviously, that whatever ice we are talking about, it might be used for your cooling purposes. Water might be for cooling, but in separate form, whatever it is. I understand till here. So there are many, especially if you talk about manufacturing. When you start your audits and articles, you will see there are lots of companies with different activities as such. And they are doing all these things, different activities. Over there, you have to understand whether it is production or not. See, when you have seen all those cleaning papers, what do you also call it as? Tissue papers, rolls. That small roll actually is cut out from a very, very big roll. It is like, you can see this size of this roll, it will be there. That level or size of rolls are created in the first place. And from that main roll, the small rolls are cut and then put into marketable, you can say, products. Now that was not a production. That is not manufacturing. What is not manufacturing? Cutting into small pieces from the big pieces. Okay, are they both of them called as a role? Yes. Are both of their purpose use of the same? Yes, cleaning and all. It is only for the sake of marketability that you cannot sell a big roll. Just like you cannot sell a big stone, you cannot sell a big roll also. It has to be marketable. No? The requirement itself is small, small units. So we cut it. So cutting from that big roll to a small roll was not a manufacturing. That all these judgments, that all these things come out. This is all a matter of litigation. This is what we understand. So just understanding of normal law is just one thing. Practical application is different. Okay, Leo, got it? Stones, yeah. Stones. So basically, this all is your litigative matter is what you were saying. All these, and these are all interesting case studies. When you go to CA final, half of your syllabus will be like case studies only. What has recently happened in some of the courts, you know, about a particular matter. Chalo, let's go ahead. Yeah. So which all were your central taxes? Which one you saw right now?
Excise.
Again, the second one is your
service tax.
On what they used to levy? On service. See, there are only two things in to sell. It's either
goods or services.
It's either goods or
services.
Hai ki nahi bachcho? When you go to a restaurant, what are you getting? You're getting both.
Yeah. Food is good and serving service.
You're getting both actually, na? You're getting food, no? Or just service. Oh, welcome to your hotel. We have nothing to serve you. Nothing. We have blank plates, huh? Go now. You pay 1,000 rupees. What for food here? Hai na? What are you getting or not? When you buy food, you're getting a good. But you're getting served food, you're also getting a good, but it is a mixture. But in GST, we'll obviously see that it is bifurcated either only in goods or services, depending on what kind of component is on a higher side. Component means what? The element. That means in the restaurant, what is more important? The food is important or the service is important? Okay, food is important. Whatever. So that, again, the problem is why? Because see, now we will see a very nice classic example. There is a restaurant, example, okay, just an example. 5 years back when GST was not there, you know. There is a restaurant, let us say in your city, they are going to sell you food, obviously. So, I mean, they are selling you food as well as service. They are going to sell you food as well as service. Okay? And VAT is on goods. See, pay attention. If a teacher or a chartered accountant or anybody is providing you a service in any city, in any state, but still the tax will be collected by center. Like any, if any academy or CA is charging you, you know, giving you service and charging you service tax in any city or state, but still the tax is going to the center. The state has no authority for that, didn't have any authority. Barabar, okay, tell you. But if anybody is selling you goods, let it be mobile, laptop, or whatever, anything rather, selling of goods in a particular city or state, on that, the tax is collected by state. So in this example of restaurant, the restaurant is selling you what? Goods as well as service. Are they going to give you separate bill for only food and only service? Do they do that? They're going to combine. Does when you go on their menu card, when you check the menu card, it is what single price? Do they bifurcate goods how much, service how much? Hai na? When you I have uttapa or butter or chicken or whatever you want, hai na? They give you one single price. That is inclusive of both. What? Both goods as well as services. Now you look from again from restaurant point of view. I think you're learning in costing as well. What are things the restaurant owner will have to keep into mind while deciding the price? First and foremost is the raw material, what is going to go. And apart from that,
services.
Like what?
Cost for services, waitering, cook.
Waitering, catering, cook, what else?
Infrastructure,
cutlery, electricity, rent, labor, all these things you have to cover on that. Yeah. Only then after the plus profit. Kuch bach gaya toh, whatever remains. You have to think of all those things, no? Isn't it? I mean, all these things will be there. Anyways, but you're going to get one single bill. Now, when the restaurant is giving you one single bill for the goods and services which they are selling you, the governments are fighting now. Which governments are fighting? The state versus center. What is, on what component or how much element will be service tax and on how much element will be VAT? Are you understanding on why? Because even goods are being sold as well as services are being sold in one single transaction. Are you understanding? So here, again, there is some kind of fight. Then central used to say, okay, on whatever bill, only 40% is service tax. Remaining will be VAT and all of that. So it
will be
percentage. Yes, I mean, you should get amount. Service tax on so much. Service tax is so much and VAT is so much. Obviously, on every invoice, tax amount is to be given. And that is actually
mandatory.
That is mandatory. Correct. Yes. Okay, Leo?
GST or VAT may be different.
वो बस सीजीएसटी एसटीसी देते हैं
नहीं जीएसटी और वैट दोनों का अलग
देते हैं अलग से नीचे देते हैं करेक्ट
फूड बिल एंड अल्कोहल बिल का अलग
यस यस करेक्ट वो अलग है बिकॉज इट इज स्टिल नॉट गॉन इन द रेजिम ऑफ जीएसटी ना दैट्स व्हाई सो दे शो इट सेपरेटली ओनली फूड अलग जीएसटी फूड एंड सर्विस डिफरेंट जीएसटी अल्कोहल वैट बिकॉज स्टिल गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट None of the governments are leaving the most revenue item, no. Alcohol and petrol. Petrol, what is the cost? Cost, 40-50 rupees. Price, 100. Abhi kitna gaya?
95.
Century hone wala hai. Century is going to happen quick. Yesterday only I got that photo. Somebody is showing that bat and helmet. Yes, in front of petrol pump. Century is going to happen soon. Yeah? 100% or actually whatever, maybe more than 100% also is only taxes. And both of them are fighting. Central also, state also. There are so many taxes. Plus the dealer's commission, the petrol pump owner's commission, and all of that. So because of taxes. The first and foremost demand in lockdown was what? To keep open petrol pump and first open alcohol. And lots of revenue even the government used to generate from that. And we'll keep the malls, cinema halls, schools, everything closed, open alcohol shops. Right? Lots of revenue. Yeah, isn't it? Yeah. Huh? Right. So even if you're buying a laptop or mobile or whatever, any kind of accessory, on that VAT needs to be there, right? But if you're doing, let us say, repairing, what about repairing, bachcho? You obviously would be given going to some garage, hai na? Are you understanding? And the garage person or the garage owner, whatever, service station, I'm going to charge both of it. What? Labor for services and material, consumables. Oil ho gaya, whatever some kind of clutch or whatever part you're changing. In that case, he's selling you goods also and also selling you service also. Okay. So all these complex things used to be there. And then even if as of today also if you go, he's going to show you separate bills. I mean GST is there, that is not a problem. But earlier times also. If you're buying some items, replace that is to be replaced in your vehicle, that is selling of goods. And normal servicing, that is selling of service. So that again both used to taxes used to be there. So there are all these things. Now if I just for the sake of example again. Electricity. Again, example, okay, electricity. We get electricity, isn't it? We are using electricity. Now, if it is a, again a classic example, pay attention. Electricity is a service or goods?
Both. Electricity is a good.
You can touch it.
But they are providing service. Providing this service, electricity, basic component is a good.
So what is a good? So all these things come to the mind of one. It should rather come to the mind. Now obviously, you want goods, I want my goods, and I want electricity. Give electricity. All you can get maximum is a battery. How can you transfer as a direct electricity from one person to another like that? You have to be like Superman for that. Right? So again, the question is that. If it is service, then service tax should be levied on that. If it is goods, then VAT should be levied on that. Again, both the departments will fight. This is not defined. Know the definition of electricity. It is goods or service. Again, that obviously an answer will get it in your electricity bill, hopefully. You can go and check it out. It is goods or service. The same thing can also be about what else? Think on these same lines. What benefit or service you can
water
get?
Supplies,
huh?
Water tax.
नहीं ठीक है लीव इट इंटरनेट लीज्ड लाइंस आर यू अवेयर लीज्ड लाइंस इंटरनेट लाइंस व्हिच यू डायरेक्टली गेट फ्रॉम दैट फाइबर ऑप्टिक एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट एट योर होम अगेन यू आर गेटिंग सर्विस और गुड्स अगेन दिस कैन बी द क्वेश्चन यू अंडरस्टैंड लीव एंड कंपोनेंट्स आर देयर करेक्ट नाउ उसमें देन नाउ यू कैन नॉट से गुड्स नाउ यू से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज गुड्स नो है ना So all these things, whatever, the data is running from there, or the currents are running from there, all these things, well, electricity rather, you know, current is running, whatever, internet, the data is running from lines and all. So again, that is a matter of understanding. So that level you have to go and you can basically reach, you know, in case of understanding. Right, Delio? Let's go ahead. And now as of today, wealth tax is not there. We have a surcharge for that. Or you can say super tax. In my times, wealth tax was also there, so we had to do income tax alone, separate. wealth tax alag, but now as of wealth tax is completely abolished in India. That doesn't mean wealth tax is not in other countries, it can be there. But wealth tax is also your direct tax only, okay? And income tax is importantly your direct tax. Okay, till here everybody, are you all understanding? What is to be done? Continue or? Continue, everybody? So let us do one important thing today. Difference between direct and indirect taxes. Because we know now there are two types of main taxes, direct and indirect, right? Let's go ahead. Too many points, but let us go through that. Both of them are taxes. Both of them will be paid by public, right? And both of them will be paid to the government. That is now quite basic. Everyone understood earlier, right? At times you also call it as treasury, okay? In your society also, you might have heard of this word treasurer. The person who is responsible for revenue, collection of money and all, hai na? So treasury of government of India is what we usually call it. The place where all the money is going to the government, right? Check. So what is direct tax? They are taxes that are levied on the income of the individuals or companies. Organization means you can say companies or any kind of legal entities. Income. Yes, till you. Fine, till you. They include examples. Income tax, that means on the person. Corporate tax, that means on the companies. Wealth, that means you have wealth. On that, you are paying some tax. Right or wrong? And inheritance tax. Again, this concept is still not in India. It is there in USA. That means when you get some wealth, you understand meaning of the word inherit? That means you are getting some wealth from your fathers, mothers, whatever, okay, family. On that also, you are getting some tax might be paid. That is all your examples of direct tax. Right? Okay, till you. Can I say there is a direct relation between your direct relation between what? Okay, not a wrong answer, but I wanted something else. Direct relation between income and
tax.
Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yes.
Direct and inverse relation means what? Direct relation means what?
Higher the income, higher the tax.
No income, no tax. Lower income, low tax. Here you have a kind of a direct relation over here, isn't it? That means a person who is earning into crores, he will pay more tax. A person who is not earning any income, he will pay no tax. Is this now, you can say, ethical or justified? Still not justified. How can you take tax from a beggar or a person who has no means to live or survive? No. Okay. Don't ask ethical questions.
That is point of view
differ. Obviously, point of view will differ. Yeah, correct. That's why we have two taxes, no? Again, just like you said, both these central union cannot survive without central and state cannot survive without each other. That is the reason we cannot abolish one of the taxes. We require both of them. Okay? Pay attention. Indirect taxes are those paid by consumers. Can I say consumer means buyers? That means spenders. Hayana.
End users,
yes. The one who's going to spend. Are you understanding or not? Correct? When they buy goods and or
services.
Hayana. Many of you, maybe some of you might not have paid income tax. Correct? Eh? But did you pay indirect tax?
Yeah. Yes.
When?
Maybe.
Khane. First thing you understand, khana, food, restaurant, hai na? Again, Starbucks. So whenever you are filling petrol also, diesel, whatever in your vehicle, you pay the taxes. Again, whenever you ate somewhere in a restaurant which charges taxes, you paid taxes. When you are buying some items, it can be stationary or not stationary, but bags, shoes, clothes, whatever, you're paying taxes, isn't it? Now that is a different scene, that it may not be your own money. You're spending someone else's money. But when you're spending, you are paying taxes. So in fact, all of them, at some point or the other, they would have obviously contributed in paying some taxes. Simple example, whenever you're buying a small mobile also, even if it is 1000 rupees mobile, you have paid taxes in buying that mobile. When you are recharging on monthly whatever basis, there is again a component of tax in that. Everywhere as such, the tax is levied. Whenever you're spending now. Are you understanding till here? Got it? डायरेक्ट टैक्स इज ऑन बेस्ड ऑन अबिलिटी टू पे एंड इट इज दियर वॉट बच्चो ऑन इन डायरेक्ट टैक्स इज अबिलिटी टू स्पेंड आई अंडरस्टैंड इट क्लियर अबिलिटी टू पे इन अबिलिटी टू अर्न इज इन केस ऑफ इनकम टैक्स एंड अबिलिटी टू स्पेंड इन केस ऑफ इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस है कि नहीं बच्चो देयर माइट बी अ माइजर ऑल्सो माइजर यू अंडरस्टैंड चिंगूस है ना हु इज अर्निंग क्वाइट वेल बट नॉट स्पेंडिंग वेल है ना so you might be paying lots of income tax but no direct taxes hey restaurant outside food no not required and our clothes only minimum required hai na nothing else no fancy thing no spending it can be like that also but indirect taxes is mainly about what based on expenditure income tax mainly based on what earning income okay tell you yes pay attention so direct taxes are based on ability to pay that means which means if you earn more you're also your tax rate is also You come in that premium class or you know cream class, but it is in indirect tax, bachcho. It is levied actually. It is shifted from one person, one taxpayer to another. That is collected by one person, but actually borne by another person. That means when you are spending, who is collecting the tax on your behalf? The person who is selling you the goods and services. When you went in a cafe or a restaurant, the restaurant charged you taxes. Are they going to keep that tax in their own pocket? Is their own income? Is your tax their income? Government will come at their home. Okay, income tax department or officials will come at the home and collect the taxes. Okay, this is not yours, this is ours. Okay, who will say that? Tax department will say that. You are kind of an agent only, collecting on behalf of the
government.
That means the person who is collecting the tax, isn't it his responsibility to pay to the government? I understand till you. Got it? The purpose of direct tax is, pay attention, to redistribute the wealth of the nations. Economic something you have like this, wealth of the nations. So whatever, take from the rich, give to poor also. So take from the rich and give it to all. But you're taking more from the rich. That is you're redistributing the wealth. Are you understanding here? I think that example, that some ratio is there. That 1% of the wealthiest people in the world, 1% of the wealthiest people in the world are actually earning or actually holding 80%, 90% of the wealth of the entire world. Only top 1% of the wealthiest people, number of people, are holding almost 80-90% of the wealth of the entire world. That kind of imbalance is there, lopsided, you know. So taking from rich and thus making them poorer, okay, but for the benefit of the poor also, you know, isn't it? Indirect taxes are levied equally upon all the taxpayers, irrespective of their income. Let us talk about mobile phones. Example, okay? Let us say, not a smartphone. And rupees 1 lakh phone, mobile phone. Example, document. Two separate examples, okay? Let us say 1000 rupees phone chalega, 1000 rupees mobile phone. And 1 lakh rupees mobile phone. Okay? Obviously, the person who can afford both of it, or rather whatever it is, as per their own capacity, they are going to be a separate class. But what is common as a percentage of tax?
Same.
It is same. Okay? When you talk about obviously the number, I mean the, you can say actual amount, it is going to be higher because the value itself is higher. But as a percentage of tax, it is going to be same. Even if the person who can afford rupees 1 lakh phone, because but if he's a miser, okay, and if he also buys 1000 rupees phone only, he's also going to pay same amount of tax also in that case because the percentage is same. Again, one of the biggest, you can say, disadvantages, or you can say, indirect taxes are also known as regressive tax. What do you mean by regressive?
Backward.
Opposite of progressive. Because here you saw, na? Yes. So direct tax is progressive. Why? Because higher the income, higher the tax. No income, no tax. That is quite logical. But indirect taxes, it is not based on income. It is based on spending. It doesn't look at you as a person. It is looking at you as a consumer. You buy this, you are paying tax. It is not going behind the picture and seeing whether you were able to afford it or not, whether you have taken loan or not to buy a particular product, but still you have to pay the tax at the same percentage or same rate, irrespective of your actual earning capacity. It is based on expenditure. So this is kind of a regressive tax, we call it. But can we abolish it? Also no. Hai na? One of the biggest examples I can tell you about, I think I'll also discuss earlier somewhere, the one of the backbone of our transport system, trucks. And trucks, they run on diesel. Again, same thing, petrol, diesel, all of them are earning lots of taxes. Correct? So whatever the percentage of taxes are levied on diesel, okay, the diesel, now pay attention, used in a truck and used in luxury car, BMW, whatever, Audi, whatever you want to, you want, okay, but still the same. Now, even if this increases by 5 rupees or 10 rupees diesel, will it affect this person? No, he is going to pay, put something more, doesn't matter. But will it affect this person?
Yeah.
Okay. How will it affect elsewhere now?
Of
direct economy. If your transport cost increases, everything which is transported right from dairy, your milk is also transported from dairy farms, even that cost will obviously will increase. It directly results into inflation, directly. All the vegetables we don't grow in our homes, we get it from farms which are not in the city. They have to be transported. If the transportation cost itself increases, obviously the cost is going to increase. They can lead to inflation in the country, isn't it? So here it is not bifurcating into actually who, which kind of person is buying that product. Are you understanding? That is why we are calling it as a regressive tax. It is just based on your spending capacity. Okay, and here obviously that is the reason we are not able to bifurcate between where actually the diesel will be used. You never know. People are taking it in the can, or in, they want to use it in home or cleaning or whatever. We don't know what is the actual purpose of that, isn't it? So here that is the reason we call it as a regressive tax. Okay, fine. I think that is enough for today, or today we'll wind up and we'll meet in the next lecture.